roller coaster ride for David Coulthard. Fuel pump problems meant he qualified in the spare car, which had been set up for teammate Mika Häkkinen.
Back when spare cars were still legal, not anymore. David Coulthard is a very good driver.
The guys who go on to win championships and multiple championships, they have those more often than not. And then you have people like myself that was able to compete with them.
He helped Red Bull become what it was today.
You know, I'd just come up short in qualifying.
In the beginning.
To describe how I felt, it would be an expletive. You know, I was really disappointed. If this had been a normal run to a first corner, then I think I probably would have overtaken Michael, but because he was able to chop across, then that cost me another position. And overtaking a Formula One is difficult, but thankfully that track and the car we had at that time allowed us to get in a position to make passes, and that was really where I was in my element, you know, wheel-to-wheel racing.
Back when
their Mercedes Formula, we first raced against each other in 1990 and Opel Lotus, and then getting in Formula 3 and then 3000. So we built always a great starter, although he ended up in front of me in that situation. But wheel to wheel, you pretty much knew if you got your nose in, you would lead in the space, which wasn't the case of Michael. So it was a lot more straightforward to race with Rubens. Because, of course, he's not going to see my hand gesture. I've got to find a way past. It was still very early in the Grand Prix, and strategy always plays a part, and it's interesting being reminded of the fact we were on some good tyres at that time, but we seem to have ample sets of new tyres, and you know, back then. So I think that allowed us to really be creative and try and find a way past, and in the end, I think the McLaren car was just too strong for the Ferrari on that day, and you know, I was motivated enough to find a space.
On lap 40, David made a decisive move at the hairpin.
Oh,
it was a very late move down the inside.
Look at Ross Brawn. Oh my gosh, when he was younger.
Back in the braking zone to really want to try and go for the inside. But I obviously released the brake, rolled the car in, and you can see that I gave Michael a little taste of his own medicine, which was a bit risky on my part because I released the steering to accelerate, and it just meant the car drifted over. But in doing so, we touched. And luckily for me, on this occasion, we just brushed wheels and I kept going. Where an
hard racing.
Previously, my rear wheel had ridden over his front wheel, and I ended up spinning. So that's just the difference sometimes. You know, millimeters make the difference between success and failure.
As it happened, Michael Schumacher retired on lap 59 with a blown engine.
Of course, Ferrari, known for that.
As I sit here now, I don't recall what I felt when I saw his car smoking outside of the track, but you understand, especially at that time, reliability was a factor in Grand Prix racing. You expected that you wouldn't finish one or two Grand Prix a season because of an engine failure or something like that. So it was the sort of natural ebb and flow of what was to be expected. So, but it was
it's okay, he still won the title.
Just, you know, psychologically and what have you, but you know, Michael wasn't down for long. He came back and he was super strong again.
Schumacher went on to win the world title that year, ahead of Häkkinen and Coulthard. But that day in France belonged to David.
Super underrated driver. Viv Coulthard, man. DC. If you know, you know.
Races as a racing driver, because I really had to overcome so many different things during the course of that weekend. I think it showed a new maturity in my performance in Grand Prix racing. You know, I had the right level of experience in developing the cars, working with the team and engineers, the confidence to really be decisive in what I wanted in terms of setup and
Ron Dennis, look at him. Oh my gosh.
I definitely was in the best shape of my racing career.